book review, but our book review today is a little different than what we usually do because all of us are in a lockdown. And being in lockdown, it's not possible for us to order online on Amazon or get any books. So we thought of doing our book review in a storytelling way so that you can show the video later on to your children and they can enjoy the whole book. To get started, today we are going to be doing Harold and the Purple Crayon by Crockett Johnson. Harold is a little boy. One evening, after thinking for some time, Harold decided to go for a walk in the moonlight. There wasn't any moon, and Harold needed a moon for a walk in the moonlight. And he needed something to walk on. He made a long, straight path so he wouldn't get lost, and he set off on his walk, taking his big purple crayon with him. But he didn't seem to be getting anywhere on the long straight path. So he left the path for a shortcut across a field and the moon went with him. The shortcut led right where Harold thought a forest ought to be. He didn't want to get lost in the woods, so he made a very small forest with just one tree. It turned out to be an apple tree. The apples would be very tasty, Harold thought, when they got red. So he put a frightening dragon under the apple tree to guard the apples. It was terribly frightening dragon. It even frightened Harold. He backed away immediately. His hand holding the purple crayon shook. And then, do you want to know what happened? Suddenly he realized what was happening. But by then Harold was over his head in an ocean. He came up thinking fast, and in no time, he was climbing aboard a tiny little boat. He quickly set a sail and the moon sailed along with him. After he had sailed long enough, Harold made a land without much trouble. He stepped ashore on the beach wondering where he was. The sandy beach reminded Harold of picnics, and the thought of picnics made him hungry. So he laid out a nice simple picnic lunch. There was nothing but pies. But there were all 9 kinds of pie that Harold liked the best. When Harold finished his picnic, there was quite a lot of food left. He hated to see so much delicious pie go to waste. And so, do you want to know what Harold did? He took his purple crayon and he drew a hungry moose and a deserving porcupine to finish it up. And off he went, looking for a hill to climb to see where he was. Harold knew that the higher he went, the farther he could see. So he decided to make the hill into a mountain. If he went high enough, he thought, he could see the window of his bedroom. Well, after all, Harold wanted to reach home. He was tired and he felt he ought to be getting to bed. He hoped he could see his bedroom window from the top of the mountain. So Harold kept on drawing and Harold kept on climbing up. Oh no, but suddenly, do you want to know what happened? Harold fell down. As he looked down over the other side, he slipped. And there wasn't any other side of the mountain. He was falling in the air. Is Harold going to get hurt? Oh no, Harold was a smart boy. And he quickly started drawing a circle. He held his purple crayon and he made a balloon. And he grabbed onto it. And he made a basket under the balloon, big enough to stand in. He had a fine view from the balloon, but he couldn't see his window. He couldn't even see a house. So he made a house with windows. And he landed the balloon in the grass in front of the yard of the house. None of the windows was his window. He tried to think where his window ought to be. He made some more windows and he made big buildings full of windows. Look at that. He made lots of buildings full of windows. He made a whole city full of windows. But none of the windows was his window. He couldn't think where it might be. He decided to ask the policeman. A policeman pointed the way Harold was going anyway. But Harold thanked him anyways. And he walked again. And he walked along with the moon, wishing he was in his room and in his bed. Then, suddenly, Harold remembered. He remembered where his bedroom window was when there was a moon. It was always right around the moon. So, Harold made his bed. He got into it and he drew up the covers. The purple crayon dropped on the floor and Harold dropped off to sleep. This is the story of a little boy who loved his purple crayon. And why I wanted to share with you guys this story is because my little one loves his purple crayon as well and loves to draw with it. Thank you for watching the video and hope you like it.